Hello everyone, you are welcome to Mining Knowledge YouTube channel. Today I am going to start new topic, that is Stowing method in mining operations. So before starting this topic, please subscribe my channel for more such videos. So let's start. What is Stowing? Stowing is a method or part of mining operations in which all the minerals of the seam is extracted out and the waste or low cost material is packed into the void spaces made by the mining operations or working. So it is simple that after creating void by extracting the minerals or taking out the minerals, there is a void created, and this void is filled up with some low cost material or some waste material to give support and protect the surface features. So this is the stowing. What are the type of stowings available? There are mainly four type of stowings available, that is hand packing, hydraulic sand stowing, mechanical stowing and pneumatic stowing. Among these, hydraulic sand stowing is very much applicable and easily it is widely used in Indian coal mines. Hydraulic sand stowing in Indian coal mines is suitably applied, and is it is in most of the Indian coal mines it is used as the hydraulic is used as a water, and sand is available, and for that purposes hydraulic sand stowing is used, where hydraulic water is used as the hydraulic media and sand is used as the stowing materials. So it is very expensive process. It is still in large scale in Indian mines, because to protect the surface features where caving operations is not allowed, in that cases we use this hydraulic sand stowing method to protect the surface features or to avoid subsidence. For though it is very costly or large expensive operations. Hydraulic sand stowing method, how it is done? Sand is transported from the source or from any river to the sand bunker or the mixing bunker, sand stowing mixer or mixing bunker or mixing chamber, and for the mixing purposes for where the stowing operations is carried out. So main part is to transport the sand from source or river to the sand bunker. Sand and water is then mixed up, and this ratio of mixing is varies from 1:1.3 to 1:2, and it depends upon the depth. Varies depth of cover or varying the depth of the seam, this ratio varies. Either it will be 1:1.3 or 1:1.5 or 1:1.2 with the sand and water ratio. This sand and water mixed up in the mixing chamber, and it is and this mixer is then transported to the underground with the help of pipeline arrangements. So after mixing up nicely, these mixers are sent to the underground mines with the help of pipeline arrangements. Before transporting to the underground, big size concrete or stones that are filtered, which may create problems during the transportation. So it is very much important that the bigger size particles or concrete to be filtered before it goes to the underground through the media of the pipeline, because if the size of the particles become more than 1/3 of the diameter of the pipe, then pipe will jam and create problems during the sand stowing operations. In underground, sand is tapped and tapped by the barrier, and water is get out from that, and these waters are collected and pumped out to the surface, which water again used for the stowing purposes. So these waters are recycled after the stowing operations, which is being carried out. Water is pumped out back to the mixing chamber. Why sand stowing is better than caving? We have another options for caving or allow to cave the roof, but we do not use the caving operations or caving method rather. In some cases we are compelled or we are forced to use sand stowing operations. Why? if any road, railway, important structures is present which is to be protected. So above the surface, if railway, important structures that is to be protected or prevented, in that cases we use sand stowing. Coal seam that is liable to spontaneous heating, in that cases we prefer for hydraulic sand stowing operations. Thick seam mining, if not possible for extract with a single lift, in that cases we use sand stowing operations for the lower seam or lower lift or upper lift. For multi-lift working operations, we use sand stowing method. If any seam working but above which seam is fire seam while all workings, in that cases we use sand stowing. So to protect the fire to come into the lower seam or protect the old workings for dangerous occurrences of any inflammable and noxious gases, we use sand stowing in the current working seams, which dangerous occurrences may come up with the above seam due to the above seam. A contiguous seam, that is the distance between two seams, if less than 9 meter distance, in that case, as deep layering operations, sand stowing method is to be applied. Seam working below waterlogged seam, if there is two seam and upper seam is waterlogged, there is a chances of coming down water due to the caving, and the lower seam operations may stop due to the heavy seepage of water or heavy accumulation of water. To avoid that, lower seam is sand stowed or sand stowing operations is done into the lower seam to protect or for good working conditions. In case of subsidence area, stowing is done to protect further subsidence, so to give natural support by stowing so that the roof does not cave in or the subsidence does not occur. To control strata nicely and avoid air blast during deep layering. In case of caving, there is a chances of air blast during deep layering district, where the exposure of the roof becomes more. In that cases, air blast may occur, which causes different damage or injury to the persons. So for safety point of view, it is very much important to control the strata nicely, and for sand stowing, if as applied, then it is better, and it is strata control is done better in a nice way, where the chances of air blast is not occur or not arises. Properties of for stowing materials, what are the properties to be what are the properties of sand stowing materials? Use and easy availability of the materials. Stowing materials must be easily transported to the mixing site from the source. So if nearby rivers there is a source of sand, there should be good communications for the transportation of sand from river to the mixing chamber. For easy available and stock purpose or storage purpose of the sand, stowing materials must be cheap and low cost. Material must be fire resistive. The material should not react with water, air, coal or other gases, form any products dangerous for mine or mine workers. So these materials to be such quality or such properties. Materials must be easily transported to underground mines through pipelines so that it cannot create jamming. During the transportation, if create jams, then the total operations will stop and create problems during the stowing method. Finer size particles are preferable for the good packing purposes. If the inter distance between these particles becomes less, then in the cases packing happens good, and the bigger size particles distance between those particles remains more, and the packing is not good for the bigger size, whereas for finer particles the packing becomes much more good for the stowing purposes. Easy to mix with water and separate easily, as sand is good stowing materials, as it easily mixed up with water and during the stowing in underground to fill up the void, it gets separated from the water easily. So sand is used for that purposes. Some important points for stowing purposes that is to be remembered, that the pipeline fittings that are fitted for the transportation of the mixing materials must be as per the proper gradient, so that it can easily transported to the underground from surface or from the mixing chamber. Sand and water ratio should be as per the depth of cover of the seam, and it should be in the range of 1.1:3 to 1.8 or 1:2 or even more, depending on the depth of cover or the requirement of the seam. Mixture of the sand water should be better to form slippery in the nature. If the mixture is good enough, in that cases transportation of the mixture becomes easy through the pipeline that is fitted. And if the mixing is not done properly, in that cases some jamming disturbance create into the pipeline, which stopped the total stowing operations. No leakage in the transporting pipelines. If there is a leakage in the transporting pipelines, leakage create much more as the times elapsed. So leakage is to be minimum for that purposes. Critical velocity of the mixture should be high enough so that there is no occurrences of jamming into the pipelines. There must be a telephonic communication between the mixing plant and the stowing district area. If there is a requirement for changing the underground pipelines, in that cases the people who are engaged for the stowing purposes, these gang of stowing people, they communicate with the people that are engaged in the mixing chamber to stop the stop or send the mixing materials into the underground during the changing of the pipeline. So there should be a good communication, telephonic communication between the underground and surface or mixing chamber people. What are the benefits of stowing? As I have already hinted the previous slide, that the leakage of air current through gulf is eliminated as when stowing is applied in any district during the deep layering purposes. So leakage of air current became minimum or eliminated. Chances of spontaneous heating, fire or fire in the adjacent panel due to air entry eliminated. If the air do not get entry into the adjacent panels, then there is no questions arises of the spontaneous heating. So spontaneous heating is reduces. Working in underground mine is safe enough as it provides the natural support into the gulf, not like the caving, which allows the roof to cave down, and it creates a problem for support as well as air blast problem during deep layering district in caving operations. Surface subsidence is avoided and strata control is done better in the stowing sand stowing operations. Accumulation of fire dam, spontaneous heating at gulf edge is minimized. As the gulf side or the void side is filled up with the stowing material, so accumulation of fire dam and spontaneous heating, chances of spontaneous heating is minimized or eliminated. With stowing method, surface structures do not disturb, like township, railway, roadway, rivers. All these are protected as the roof does not cave in. As usual, it remains. So these structures of like railway, roadway or rivers, ponds, all these are protected or prevented. Thick seam, contiguous seam can be extracted easily with multi-lift working operations, where the stowing operations is done either the lower lift or the upper lift. What are the drawback or demerits of the stowing operations? There are few demerits or drawbacks of the stowing operations that are more manpower engaged. This operations does not required for the caving operations, but in case of stowing operations, additional manpower required for the stowing only. High cost per ton of stowing due to stowing, as the sand is to be purchased from the local organization or from the local state government, and transportation cost as well as manpower cost, all these costs are added and the cost per ton of coal or materials is increased. Availability and purchase issues of stowing materials due to state policies. In some states, there is some mineral development policies. Due to that, each and every person or organizations cannot buy, or there is some limitations policies during purchasing of such stowing materials. If it is not available easily, in that cases, stowing operations is stopped, and indirectly the total production is also stopped due to the stowing operations, as the permissible void limit is limited. Low production rate, as the stowing cannot be advanced in such high speed. If the production rate is increased, in that cases the stowing operations is also to be increased in the same ratio, but stowing operations cannot be increased as per the production increment. So if the proportionality is not maintained, in that cases there should be a gap of the production rate and the void spaces. If the void spaces is much more, in that cases it is not permitted and the production is stopped in some times to get more stowing operations or to fill up the void spaces in high speed than the production rate. Humidity and pumping problems of water. During the stowing operations, the water is accumulated into the underground, which creates the humidity problem, as well as the water is to be pumped out into the surface. So pumping arrangements is to be maintained in a smooth manner, or a smooth operations is to be maintained for the pumping purposes. Flow rate of stowing rate is not achieved in high speed, as there are several factors like the availability of sand, water, and the mixing chamber is limited capacity, and these are to be transported with the help of pipeline. So all these factors creates the slow speed of the stowing rate. Please subscribe this channel for watching this. Thank you for watching this. Don't forget to subscribe.